Hello everyone, Jai Hind everybody. Welcome to Arpita Sharma Classes. I am Arpita Sharma, your educator. And today we are going to analyze the Hindu newspaper. Aap sabhi ka swagat hai Arpita Sharma Classes mein. Jai Hind, main hoon Arpita Sharma, aap sabhi ki educator. Aur aaj hum the Hindu newspaper analyze karenge. Now here's a small announcement for all of those students who are beginners in this preparation or who have just now joined the channel and they are watching this video, this class for the first time. अब उन सभी स्टूडेंट्स के लिए एक छोटी सी अनाउंसमेंट है जिन्होंने आज ही ये चैनल ज्वाइन किया है या जो आज ही इस क्लास को अटेंड कर रहे हैं पहली बार. द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस क्लास विल बी अपलोडेड ऑन अ टेलीग्राम चैनल. द नेम ऑफ द चैनल इज सिंप्लीफाइंग यूपीएससी विद ईज. देयर इज अ टेलीग्राम ऐप, यू कैन इंस्टॉल इट एंड इन दैट यू कैन फाइंड द चैनल सिंप्लीफाइंग यूपीएससी विद ईज. द लिंक ऑफ दैट चैनल इज गिवन बिलो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. And the class will be conducted in both the languages, Hindi and English. Class को दोनों languages में conduct किया जाएगा, हिंदी में भी English में भी, so that the students who are Hindi medium students, the students who are English medium students can both comfortably attend that session. Now here's a small announcement with this very about this very wonderful app which I just came across. My team just came across this particular app, Trackyy IAS syllabus tracker. Now this is by far so far the best app to help us inculcate discipline within ourselves. अब तक बहुत सारे ऐप्स हमने देखे हैं बट ये जो ऐप हमारे नजरों में आया है ये एक ऐसा ऐप है जो कि आपको कहते हैं ना एक साइलेंट फ्रेंड की तरह एक्ट करेगा, एक साइलेंट गुरु की तरह एक्ट करेगा जो आपको समय समय पर एक डंडा बजाता रहेगा सर पे कि भाई इतना तुमने कंप्लीट नहीं किया सिलेबस, इतना भी और पढ़ना बाकी है, इतना ही चले हो और आगे बढ़ना बाकी है. राइट, व्हाट हैपेंस इज इन अ डे टू डे प्रिपरेशन वी ऑल आर डूइंग सेल्फ स्टडी. राइट, आप सभी यू ऑल आर डूइंग द सेल्फ स्टडी. Now some of you might have also joined coaching center but then at the end of that you are also doing self study. Coaching se wapas ghar aate ho to padhte ho na khud hi. When you come back home from your coaching you study yourself na, so that is a part of self study only. So you all are doing self study but in the self study sometimes students lose track of time or track of syllabus and then exam approach karta jata hai, ghabrahat badhti jati hai. As soon as the exam approaches the fear, the you know anxiety approaches. Right, that this much we have to complete. We do not know how much we have completed so far. हमने रटा भी, learn भी किया है कि नहीं, समझा भी है या नहीं, ढंग से रटा भी है कुछ या नहीं. Right, so this app is going to help you in that. Particularly, it is useful for UPSC IAS aspirants, those who lose track of preparation, those who are worried that they might forget things they have to do, those who want to consistently remind themselves of what they need to do. So what this app will do is, this app will help you to keep a track of the syllabus. Keep a hold over the syllabus. You can download it from the Google Play Store. The link is given in the description box down below the video. Now what this app will do is it has segregated the UPSC syllabus, UPSC CSE syllabus into different subjects. Okay, syllabus ko different subjects mein isne kya kiya hai, divide kar diya hai. For example, GS paper 1 has been divided in different parts of syllabus. One of them is Indian art and culture, and then Indian art and culture within this also it is divided into various topics like Indus Valley civilization, Buddhist architecture, etc., etc. So once you, first of all, it is also helping you in, you know, making you understand the syllabus, what you have to study. It will tell you this much only you have to study. ये आप आपको automatically बताएगा आपको Indus Valley civilization architecture portion में सिर्फ ये पढ़ना है. And it is also going to suggest you books from which you have to study. Here it is suggesting Nitin Singhania sir's book, right? तो आपको ये topic suggest करेगा, बताएगा UPSC के pattern के सिलेबस के हिसाब से कि आर्किटेक्चर में ये भाई यही पढ़ना है. ठीक है, तो आप जैसे जैसे कंप्लीट करते जाओगे टॉपिक्स, एज सून एज यू आर कंप्लीटिंग द टॉपिक्स यू विल जस्ट टिक ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर चेकलिस्ट. इस चेकलिस्ट में आप टिक कर दोगे एंड देन इट विल टेल यू दैट इन इंडियन आर्ट एंड कल्चर इन द आर्किटेक्चर पोर्शन हाउ मच परसेंटेज ऑफ टॉपिक यू हैव कंप्लीटेड, हाउ मच परसेंटेज ऑफ सिलेबस यू हैव कंप्लीटेड. जैसे जैसे टिक लगाते जाओगे आपको ये ऐप बताता जाएगा ऑटोमेटिकली 15% आपने आर्किटेक्चर कंप्लीट कर लिया है. So you will get a sense of accomplishment. Yes, we are going somewhere. We are heading somewhere. वरना रोज क्या होता है, टारगेट्स लिख तो लेते हैं रजिस्टर में, उनमें से चार टॉपिक्स लिखे हैं तो दो ही कंप्लीट कर पाएंगे, फिर कैरी फॉरवर्ड कर देंगे दूसरे दिन. What happens in daily life? You will write down four topics for one day to complete. Then you will end up completing only two and the two, other two will be carry forward to the next day. That will increase your laziness. But this app will help you decrease your laziness. It will help you in revising. You can add deadlines also for syllabus topics. You can, you know, add topics in the my task list also. It will help you in covering the topics in prelims and mains. Prelims or mains, dono mein helpful hoga. ओके, यू कैन सेट डेडलाइंस ऑल्सो फॉर यू. अपने लिए डेडलाइंस भी सेट कर सकते हो. यू कैन मार्क द टॉपिक वंस दे आर कंप्लीटेड. एंड फॉर प्रीलिम्स इट इज फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. प्रीलिम्स के लिए तो बिल्कुल फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट है. फॉर मेंस यू हैव टू टेक एनुअल सब्सक्रिप्शन. मेंस के लिए आपको एनुअल सब्सक्रिप्शन लेनी पड़ेगी. फॉर दैट यू विल गेट 130 रुपीज का डिस्काउंट बाय यूजिंग दिस रेफरल कोड अर्पिता शर्मा 1. इस रेफरल कोड को यूज करते हो अगर अर्पिता शर्मा 1 को, तो आपको रुपीज 130 का डिस्काउंट भी मिल जाएगा एनुअल सब्सक्रिप्शन के ऊपर. एज यू कैन सी द फीस इज वेरी मिनिमम फॉर एनुअल सब्सक्रिप्शन. ईयरली सब्सक्रिप्शन 495. एंड यू विल यूज द कोड अर्पिता शर्मा 1. यू विल अप्लाई इट एंड देन द फिगर विल बी, यू कैन से डिक्रीज 365 में आपको ये ऐप एक तरीके का गुरु बनकर आपके सामने आएगा. राइट, क्लियर एवरीवन? सो द लिंक टू डाउनलोड दिस ऐप इज गिवन बिलो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. यू कैन डाउनलोड इट. नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रीलिम्स एमसीक्यू टेस्ट. देर विल बी एवरी डे 4 क्वेश्चंस विच आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क यू. ओके, इन द हिंदू एनालिसिस क्लासेस हर दिन मैं 4 क्वेश्चंस आपसे पूछा करूंगी बेस्ड ऑन द करंट अफेयर्स वी हैव कवर्ड प्रीवियसली. लास्ट 2 महीने में जो भी करंट अफेयर्स हमने कवर किए हैं उसके बेसिस पे दीज 4 क्वेश्चंस विल बी मेड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न काउंसिल. सो अबाउट नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न काउंसिल्स 3 स्टेटमेंट्स आर गिवन. यू हैव टू फर्स्ट कंसिडर देम, मीन्स यू हैव टू रीड देम, पढ़ते हैं. चलो, फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट, नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न काउंसिल एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय एन एक्ट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट इज द नोडल एजेंसी फॉर द इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन. इफ यू हैव नॉट स्टडीड द न्यूज़पेपर देन ऑल्सो इट इज अ वेरी कॉमन सेंस बेस्ड क्वेश्चन. अब जो बच्चे बोल रहे हैं मैम हमने तो ये टॉपिक न्यूज़पेपर में पढ़ा नहीं तो हम क्या ये क्वेश्चन पूरा का पूरा छोड़ देंगे, देखो कॉमन सेंस अप्लाई करोगे तो जिंदगी को पार कर पाओगे. कॉमन सेंस के बिना जीना शुरू करोगे तो 2 कदम भी आगे नहीं चल पाओगे. राइट और रॉन्ग? राइट ना. इफ यू अप्लाई कॉमन सेंस यू कैन यू नो फाइंड सक्सेस इन दिस लाइफ इन एवरी स्फीयर. बट इफ यू डू नॉट अप्लाई योर कॉमन सेंस इन योर डे टू डे लिविंग देन यू कैन नॉट बी एबल टू कवर अ लिटिल डिस्टेंस. राइट, उतर के आप पलंग से भी 2 मिनट आगे नहीं चल सकते अगर कॉमन सेंस यूज नहीं करते हो. सो हियर इफ यू अप्लाई कॉमन सेंस दिस स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट. अगर कॉमन सेंस अप्लाई करते हो तो ये स्टेटमेंट सही है. नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न काउंसिल है, नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न ऑब्वियसली इट इज वर्किंग फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ और डेवलपमेंट ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन. राइट नाउ, एंड यू ऑल्सो नो इफ इट्स एन काउंसिल इट मस्ट हैव बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय एन एक्ट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. अब ये काउंसिल है नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन के लिए काम कर रहा है, ऑब्वियसली एक्ट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट के द्वारा एस्टैब्लिश किया गया होगा. राइट, बिकॉज स्पेशली इट इज वर्किंग फॉर अ रीजन इन आर कंट्री. सो फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट बाय अप्लाइंग कॉमन सेंस करेक्ट. Second statement, Minister of Development of NER is the ex-officio chairman of North Eastern Council, ex-officio chairman. Now this statement can only be answered if you have studied the current affair because there were some major developments in the past. Ye statement tabhi aap sahi mark kar sakte ho jab current affair padha hai. Third statement, initially Sikkim was not part of North Eastern Council and was added to the council in year 2002. Again, a very static part. If you have studied current affair, you will be able to answer this statement. Now you have to tell me which one of them is correct. Incorrect, nahi, correct. In mein se kaun sa correct hai statement. Now by common sense, first statement is correct. So one is here also and here also. Rest of the statement, you can only mark them correct or incorrect if you have studied the current affairs. Now tell me in the comment section, let's see how many students are really focusing in the classes. डेली जनवरी मंथ में, फरवरी मंथ में किसने अब तक क्लासेस में सीरियसली दिमाग लगाया है, पढ़े हैं जो बच्चे, वही इस क्वेश्चन को आंसर कर सकते हैं. टेल मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज बी. बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. स्टेटमेंट 1 and 3 आर करेक्ट. स्टेटमेंट 2 इज रॉन्ग. व्हाई? बिकॉज होम मिनिस्टर इज द एक्स ऑफिशियो यू नो चेयरमैन ऑफ North is the chairman of North Eastern Council. Home Minister जो है वो North Eastern Council के chairman हुए हैं. ये बात 2018 में change हुई थी. In 2018 the chairmanship from Minister of Development was given to Home Minister. First and third statement are correct. Yes, Sikkim was initially not part of this council, but in 2002 it was added. And NEC was established by the North Eastern Council Act of 1971. All right? Clear everyone? Now answer second question. Now this question can very easily be answered if you have dedicatedly and very focusedly, very seriously attended the classes. बहुत ही फोकस तरीके से क्लास अटेंड करिए ना हिंदू की, तो आप आंसर कर सकते हो. कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट. सो फर्स्ट रीड, लेट अस रीड द स्टेटमेंट बिकॉज द एग्जामिनर इज आस्किंग अस टू कंसिडर देम. आर्टिकल 341, 10,000 बार पढ़ा होगा हमने ये, ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन प्रोवाइड सर्टन प्रिविलेजेस एंड कंसेशंस टू द मेंबर्स ऑफ शेड्यूल कास्ट. सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट, President alone is vested with the power to include or exclude any entry in scheduled caste list. Now, third statement is very easy to answer if you have studied class 11th NCERT of Pol Science. Pol Science ki NCERT padhi hai na, third chapter mein. Third statement can be answered if you have studied chapter number 3 of class 11th NCERT. There is provision for reservation of scheduled caste both in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Now, which of the above statement is or are incorrect? Now students who are in a hurry, they often miss this particular word, they often read it as correct. जो भाग दो भागने में लगे हैं ना बच्चे, वो क्या करते हैं, वो क्या इसको करेक्ट पढ़ लेते हैं कि भाई इसमें पूछा गया है कौन सा स्टेटमेंट करेक्ट होगा, बट द एग्जामिनर इज आस्किंग टू टेल टू यू नो इट इज आस्किंग टू आइडेंटिफाई विच वन इज इनकरेक्ट. नाउ टेल मी इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन विच वन इज इनकरेक्ट, कौन सी स्टेटमेंट गलत है. So the correct statement, incorrect statement is statement 2 and 3. Statement 2 and 3 are incorrect. 2 and 3 incorrect. Statement 1 is correct. Why? Because yes, article 341 of the constitution provides certain privileges and concessions to the members of scheduled caste. Scheduled caste ke members ko kuch privileges aur kuch concessions diye jaate hain article 341 ke tahat. Article 341, under the provision of this article, first list of scheduled caste in relation to states or union territory is to be issued by notified order of the president after consulting concerned state government. So first statement is correct. Now let's come to statement number 2. Ab statement number 2 ki taraf jaate hain. President alone is vested. Alone is an extreme word. Jahan bhi extreme word aa jaye, look out for the extreme words. Only, alone, these are extreme words. So there is 99% chance that it can be wrong. जहां ये एक्सट्रीम वर्ड्स आ जाते हैं वो 99% चांस हो जाते हैं कि वो रॉन्ग होगा. वो 1% रिस्क आपको लेना है. एंड यू नो इफ देयर इज रिस्क ओनली देन देयर इज प्रॉफिट, राइट? वरना विदाउट रिस्क यू कैन लिव अ मीडियोकर लाइफ, बट व्हेन यू टेक रिस्क ऑब्वियसली देयर आर हाई चांसेस दैट यू विल सक्सीड. सो स्टेटमेंट 2 इज इनकरेक्ट. अंडर द प्रोविजन ऑफ आर्टिकल 341 दिस वी हैव स्टडीड. नाउ पार्लियामेंट अलोन इज वेस्टेड, नॉट प्रेसिडेंट. Parliament alone is vested with the power to include or exclude any entry in the scheduled caste list under 341, article 341. Statement 2 is wrong. Statement number 3, there is provision for reservation of scheduled caste both in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. No, there is provision for reservation only in the Lok Sabha. So NCERT agar padhi hai to do number to aasani se NCERT plus the Hindu newspaper if you are studying it regularly religiously. Now two numbers are your, two number is your, two marks are yours. Okay, state question number 3. Now this question can be answered if you have studied yesterday's newspaper. Kal ka newspaper padha hai to bahut easy hai. 15th finance commission, we talked about it, right, has considered which of the following parameters to arrive at state share in divisible pool of taxes. 2011 population census, forest cover, area of the state, demographic performance. 15th फाइनेंस कमीशन ने इनमें से कौन से पैरामीटर्स को ऐड किया है पूल ऑफ डिविजिबल पूल ऑफ टैक्सेस को के में से स्टेट का शेयर निकालने के लिए. करेक्ट आंसर इज यस, ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑल ऑफ दीज हैव बीन इंक्लूडेड. 15th फाइनेंस कमीशन हैज रिड्यूस्ड द वर्टिकल डेवोल्यूशन फ्रॉम 42% to 41%. इट हैज यूज्ड क्राइटेरियन ऑफ डेमोग्राफिक एफर्ट to offset population parameter, and it has considered 2011 population census, forest cover, tax effort, area of state, demographic performance to arrive at the state's share in divisible pool of profits of taxes. Question number 4. Consider the following statements regarding wetlands conservation and management rules 2017. First, the rules have been framed under Environment Protection Act 1986. Second, these rules shall apply to wetlands falling in areas covered under Wildlife Protection Act 1972 and Forest Conservation Act 1980. Third, rules stipulate setting up of a state wetlands authority in each state and union territories who will develop a comprehensive list of activities to be regulated and permitted within the notified wetlands and their zone of influence. This statement can be marked correct or incorrect by common sense. Now tell me which of the above statements is or are correct. Batao isme se correct statement kaun si hai? Correct statement is C. That is statement 1 and 3 are correct. Statement number 2 is wrong. Why statement number 2 is wrong? Because these rules, the applicability of rules are, this will apply to following wetlands or wetland complexes, namely wetland categorized as wetland of international importance under Ramsar Convention. It is not Ramsar. Wetlands as notified by central government, state and union territory administration. That is also not here. Provided that these rules shall not apply to wetlands, it will not apply to wetlands who are falling under this category. So this statement is wrong. Is category mein, is act mein jo bhi wetland aate hain, us pe ye rules nahi lagenge. Theek hai? Now let us decode the news for today. The first news, need not write it down, need not copy it. Isko likhne ki zarurat nahi hai, just understand it. It is important just for your ethics paper, just for your essay paper. Okay, GS paper 1, social issues. The center said the term love jihad is not defined under the law and no such case has been reported by any of the central agencies. Jo love jihad ke upar jo bawal uttha rehta hai, ye love jihad jo term hai na, ye hi kisi bhi law mein defined nahi hai. Union Minister of State for Home G. Kishan Reddy said Article 25 of Constitution provides for freedom to profess, practice and propagate religion subject to public order, morality and health. The term love jihad is not defined under extant laws. No such case of love jihad has been reported by any of the central agencies where definition is required. Okay, so this is a factual information which you should know. Two in quarantine for N coronavirus flee to Saudi. Two persons who had returned from China recently were under observation because of the infection. Okay, but they have left the country for Saudi Arabia and violated the state health department's instruction to remain under home quarantine. So, unhone violate kiya, unko kaha gaya tha, aapko quarantine mein rehna hai, but ye log Saudi Arabia chale gaye hain. So, about coronavirus, we have studied, achche se detail mein we have studied everything about coronavirus. So, no need to write it down if you have already made notes on coronavirus. Now comes the next important news. No decision yet on Pan India. Pan means all. All India NRC, minister tells parliament. Now the government has informed the Lok Sabha that till now it has not taken any decision to prepare national register of citizens at national level. अभी तक गवर्नमेंट ने इन्फॉर्म किया लोकसभा को बताया कि अभी तक हमने कोई फैसला नहीं लिया है कि हम नेशनल रजिस्टर ऑफ सिटीजन एनआरसी को नेशनल लेवल पर बनाएं. अभी हम सिर्फ एनपीआर एक्सरसाइज के बारे में सोच रहे हैं. नेशनल लेवल पे एनआरसी को निकालने की कोई चर्चा अभी तक कोई फैसला हमने नहीं लिया है. सो फार इन द लास्ट 4 months वी हैव स्टडीड इन डिटेल अबाउट नेशनल रजिस्टर ऑफ सिटीजन. वी हैव ऑल्सो सेपरेटली मेड अ वीडियो ऑन नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर. लिंक इज गिवन बिलो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. नेशनल पॉपुलेशन रजिस्टर एनपीआर क्या है, उसके रेपरकशंस क्या होंगे, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स क्या है, ये सब एक वीडियो में हमने बना रखा है. नीचे डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में लिंक दिया हुआ है. वी हैव ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन वॉट इज यूजुअल रेजिडेंट इन दैट वीडियो. लिंक इज गिवन बिलो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. ओके, सो यू कैन गो थ्रू दैट वीडियो एंड इट विल बी क्लियर. Next important news, why no action on pleas on Tamil Nadu MLA's disqualification, asked Supreme Court. The Supreme Court gave Tamil Nadu Speaker P. Dhanpal a week's time to inform when he will take the cognizance of the disqualification petitions filed under 10th schedule anti-defection law against Deputy Chief Minister O. Paneer Selvam. Now here what you have to study is, you have to study the 10th schedule anti-defection law. Yahan par hame प्रिलिम्स के लिए ये पढ़ना है. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रिलिम्स एज वेल एज जीएस पेपर 2. हाउ कैन एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ बी मेड मोर स्ट्रॉन्गर, मोर स्ट्रिंजेंट? कैसे एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ को ज्यादा क्लियर, ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्गर, ज्यादा स्ट्रिंजेंट बनाया जा सकता है? ये जीएस पेपर 2 के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है. एंड द फीचर्स इन द प्रोविजन ऑफ 10th स्केड्यूल एंड एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रिलिम्स. I've already told you that once in a week I'll be making a video wherein I'll be telling you how to decode the newspaper. मैंने आपको पहले ही बताया था, first Feb के time पे ही बताया था शायद, कि हफ्ते में एक बार, no, 29th Jan I made this announcement, 29th Jan 2020 I made this announcement, कि हफ्ते में एक बार मैं आपको एक वीडियो के थ्रू बताया करूंगी कैसे हिंदू को डिकोड करना है, क्या क्या पॉइंट्स नोट डाउन करने हैं, okay? So that you can inculcate a habit of reading the newspaper and making notes yourself. Now this news is extremely important for prelims. ये सिर्फ prelims के लिए important है, only for prelims. Supreme as the chief minister to dedicate UNESCO certificate for Jaipur. Rajasthan chief minister will dedicate United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization World Heritage Site certificate for Jaipur to the people at a function here. So which city has been given this particular UNESCO World Heritage Site certificate? It is Jaipur. Remember this for prelims. Prelims के लिए याद रखना. Now, over here, Mr. Azoulay's visit to Jaipur assumes significance after UNESCO declared World City famous for its grid plan based architecture and buildings constructed with the pink facade as World Heritage. Last year announcement hui thi, International Council on Monuments and Sites had earlier inspected the city in 2018 once it was nominated, and then 2019 it was given this certificate. The council took into account now what has been appreciated by UNESCO. You have to remember it. Kis cheez ki sarahana hui hai? Architecture of the streets. Streets ke architecture ki sarahana hui hai yahan par. Okay, so you have to keep in mind that also. The architecture of streets with colonnades which intersect the center creating large public squares called chowpars. So this you have to study for your prelims. The uniform facades of market, residence and temples in the main streets had also impressed the council. So basically, overall the architecture has been appreciated. Architecture ko appreciate kiya gaya hai. Okay? The capital city of Jaipur, included in the list of World Heritage Sites, was founded in 1727 by the then Kachwaha Rajput ruler of Amer, Swai Jaisingh II. The city was established on the plains and built according to a grid plan interpreted in the light of Vedic architecture. So in the architecture, Vedic architecture has been followed, and it was founded by in 1727 by Swai Jaisingh II. So itna yaad rahega na, it was founded in 1727. So remember these facts. These are important for your prelims. Now the next states have to decide on their capital, says Union Minister. Union Minister of State for Home, Nityanand Rai, said that states had to decide on their capitals within their territory. Now, why this statement has come? Because of the AP government, which is being committed to developing three capitals. This news we covered in November 2019 in a very holistic manner. November 2019, December 2019, mein humne ye news kaafi achche se cover kari thi, kaafi clearly. You have to tell me the name of those three capitals which are being proposed in by the AP government. नीचे comment section में बताओ आंध्र प्रदेश government जो है वो कौन सी तीन capitals की बात कर रही है इधर? कौन सी तीन capitals लाने की बात कर रही है? बताओ जल्दी. Tell me which three capitals is the आंध्र प्रदेश government asserting on that we should create these capitals. The name of those three capitals are Amravati, Vishakhapatnam, Kurnool. Amravati, you know, they are saying that it can become the legislative capital. Vishakhapatnam can become the executive capital and Kurnool can become the judicial capital. They are copying the idea from South Africa. In South Africa also there are three capitals. Pretoria, which is the administrative capital. Cape Town, which is the legislative capital, and Bloemfontein, which is the judicial capital. And the constitutional court of South Africa is established in, it is located in Johannesburg. Okay, so they are trying to copy South Africa in this case. Now a fire rages near the Orumanda hamlet. Now here this is important for prelims. Ye aapke prelims ke liye kaafi important hai. It is in the Amrabad Tiger Reserve, which is in Nagar Kurnool district, Telangana. So this is important for prelims. Where is Amrabad Tiger Reserve is located? Kahan par located hai? It is located in Telangana. Okay, remember the geographical location. Geographical location yaad rakhna. Healing Cry Statue enters URF Book of World Records. This is only important for prelims. Very, very important. Two number aapke matter karte hain, depend karte hain. A trimetal sculpture of Jesus Christ, Healing Christ, which is said, on the central courtyard of Believers Church Medical College in Tiruvala, has entered the Universal Record Forum's Book of World Records. URF team adjudged that 368 centimeter tall statue weighing 2400 kg is the largest one of its kind in the world. So remember this, which you know, sculpture has found its place in the URF Book of World Records. It is the trimetal sculpture of Jesus Christ, which is known as Healing Christ. Agar aap koi bank ka exam bhi de rahe ho na, tab bhi ye news important. If you are giving bank exam, RBI exam, then also this is important. 7 in 100 Anganwadi beneficiaries in cities. Very important for GS paper 3, GS paper 1. Mains, it is only important for mains. And also 20% important for your prelims. 80% important mains ke liye hai, 20% prelims ke liye. For every 100 Anganwadi beneficiaries in the country, only 7 are in urban areas. जितने भी 100 beneficiaries हैं total, उनमें से 7 आंगनवाड़ीज जो हैं, वो सिर्फ urban areas में ही है. आंगनवाड़ीज are also known as daycare centers. They are set up. Now this is important for prelims. I am underlining it. Okay, highlighting it. इसको लिख लो, just write it down. Set up under integrated child development services by which ministry? Women and Child Development Ministry. For what? To provide a package of 6 services. The 6 services are, you have to remember that also. Supplementary nutrition, preschool non-formal education, immunization, nutrition and health education, referral services. What is the aim of establishing Anganwadis? Aim of this scheme is to reduce infant mortality, child malnutrition. And who are the beneficiaries? Children in the age group of 6 months to 6 years, pregnant women and lactating mothers. Okay, clear everyone? Now there were total 7.95 crore beneficiaries of Anganwadi scheme in the country. Only 55 lakh were registered at urban Anganwadis. Now why this? Why? What is the reason behind this deficiency? What is the reason behind this deficiency? This is primarily because of an acute paucity of or lack of Anganwadi centers in urban areas. Clear everyone? So you have to go through these facts. In facts ko padh lo, these facts can be used in your mains answer writing. And these particular paragraphs, 2 paragraphs are important only for your prelims. Ye paragraph prelims ke liye important hai. And this, the factual paragraph is important for mains. Bhutan ends free entry for Indian tourist. Bhutan ends free entry for Indian tourist. Now, ending decades of free entry to Indian tourists visiting Bhutan, the government in Thimphu has decided to levy a daily 1200 fee for regional tourists from India, the Maldives and Bangladesh beginning July 2020. Now, the fee is known as Sustainable Development Fee. You have to remember which country is charging this Sustainable Development Fee. Okay? Clear? It is meant to help the government deal with increasing numbers in tourist traffic, which it is seeking to regulate through a new tourism policy. The decision was passed by National Assembly as a tourism levy and exemption bill of Bhutan 2020. SDF is considerably lower than $65, which is charged by the other foreign tourists. Indians mainly travel to more developed western region of Bhutan. In a move to promote tourism in Bhutan's eastern region as well, government has decided to drop the SDF charges for tourists visiting 11 of 20 total districts that fall under the east from Trongsa to Trashigang. Okay. Now again, this particular news is important for your prelims, very important for prelims and very important for GS paper 3 mains. Medical details of over 120 million Indian patients have been leaked and made freely available on the internet. Greenbone Sustainable Resilience, which is a German cyber security firm, has released this data. In the security, the cyber security is important for GS paper 3, and this topic is important for GS paper 3. Greenbone Sustainable Resilience, remember which firm, German cyber security firm, has released this data for prelims. Prelims ke liye naam yaad rakhna, country ka bhi naam yaad rakhna. What is even more worrying is that number of data troves containing this sensitive data went up by a significant number in the Indian context. The first report was published in October last year. जितने भी सीटी स्कैन्स होते हैं, एक्सरेज होते हैं, एमआरआईज हैं, पिक्चर्स के साथ पेशेंट्स की सारी डिटेल इंटरनेट पर लीक कर दी गई है. ओके, दिस लीक वॉज फैसिलिटेटेड बाय द फैक्ट दैट द पिक्चर आर्काइविंग एंड कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम पैक्स servers where these details are stored are not secure and linked to public internet without any protection, making them easily accessible to malicious elements. Then they exploit people based on their information, right? That is very dangerous and harmful right now. Next important news, no rules were broken, says NCBS. Under the scanner, after government ordered an inquiry into a study conducted in Nagaland by researchers from US, China and India on bats and humans carrying antibodies to deadly virus like Ebola, the National Center for Biological Sciences, the NCBS, it said that researchers based at the NCBS collected samples of serum from bats and humans, and these samples were tested at the NCBS with technology supplied by Duke National University of Singapore Medical School. So there was no violation of any rules while this research was going on, it has been said by NCBS. So you have to remember what is NCBS, what is the composition of NCBS, and what was the result of this research, which we have discussed 2-3 days back also. Another news, world is not facing a pandemic yet. Abhi tak bilkul isko WHO ne bola hai ki ye pandemic disease nahi hai. The World Health Organization said that the outbreak of coronavirus does not constitute a pandemic right now. Okay, we are at a phase where it is an epidemic with multiple, side effects, multiple repercussions. Isko abhi epidemic kaha gaya hai, but pandemic nahi banaya gaya hai. What is pandemic? Pandemic means a disease which is prevalent over a whole country or the world. Pandemic वो होती है एक ऐसी disease जो कि पूरे विश्व में फैल चुकी है. तो अभी तक इसको pandemic घोषित नहीं किया गया है. All right? So this was all for today. I hope you enjoyed the class. I hope आपको class अच्छी लगी हो. If you really enjoyed it, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and share this video with the other aspirants as well. Thank you.